Rob, thanks for joining us here today. It's great to speak with you, and I really enjoyed your talk earlier as part of Swami's keynote. Can we just start by maybe just understanding a bit more about your role? I think it's a super interesting, compelling kind of like role that you have at Booking.com. Tell us a bit more.
Sure. As the Chief Technology Officer, I'm responsible for a lot of the core platforms that are used by all the business units. You know, so our business is comprised of accommodations, flights, right, taxis, attractions, all sorts of other things. But all of that is built on the core platforms that I run an organization called Central Technology.
Okay.
That all the teams then make use of.
And I mean, Booking.com, you know, many of us are familiar with it as travelers, right, engaging in it that way, but it's actually an effective marketplace as well that has two sides to it. So how much of the platforms, the systems that you create are a part of that wider marketplace play? Maybe tell us a bit more about that.
Yeah, indeed, we are a two-sided marketplace. And so yeah. I always think of it as the co-creation of value between supply and demand. So, you know, travelers come because they know they're going to get great selection, price, availability, whereas our partners come because they know the incremental demand happens through a platform.
Right.
So, you know, all that technology is powered on the same stacks, essentially. So,
right. Give us a feel for the scale of it. Like, I know you guys, you know, cover a broad reach, but like, you know, how big is big?
Yeah. Well, if you think of it in our business, for example, yeah, I think I mentioned in the keynote today, 28 million listings in the accommodation space alone. So we talked about data today, obviously. It's hard to manage. So, you know, we manage, you know, over 150 petabytes of data,
right,
on premise today. So
oh,
one
wow.
of the things we're doing is, you know, part of our data modernization strategy is making use of AWS to make life easier.
Right, right. So data is a core part of your team's scope and function as well. Aside from it residing on premise, what are some of the challenges you're grappling with a business at that scale and a marketplace that is that dynamic? Like, what are some of the day-to-day challenges that you guys have around data?
You know, in many ways, the problems that are not invented at Booking, you know,
right,
it's just the explosion of data that's happened over the years. Everybody runs into the same challenges. So you have to make sure that, you know, you have the right governance in place for respecting
yeah.
privacy. You know, and just even understanding the lineage of data and the quality of the data. So those are not unique to Booking. They're just at our size. It's maybe harder to do at times.
Sure thing. Sure thing.
But we have the same challenges that everyone has. Maybe what's a little bit unique is because we are in the EU, you know, the regulatory landscape there is, you know, is constantly evolving. So we work closely with the EU Parliament as well.
Right.
So that we stay close to them, especially on ML ethics, AI ethics, because
okay.
I think that's going to be important.
That's great. And obviously data is very important for ML and AI.
Indeed.
More so than ever right now with generative AI on the scene, you know, people are really having to look at their data quality to be able to scale generative AI effectively. Like, how's that working out for you guys? You spoke a bit earlier today about one of your first AI, I think it was Travel Planner.
Yeah, the AI Trip Planner.
Trip Planner.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, how's that going as a first use case, and how are you scaling that, and how does that connect with your data?
Yeah, so for us, it's, you know, it's just a toe in the water. Honestly, we think there's a lot
right.
more we can do. But in terms of making use of our data, the thing that I'm very cautious of, I want to make sure that we're always maintaining trust with our customers. So
right.
the privacy side of that is crucial. So the way I kind of think about it mm-hmm. is, you know, teams want to take advantage of whatever technology is out there. But one of the things that I, you know, sort of adhere to is from an enterprise perspective, if we are going to be building our own models, which we're going to want to do, we're going to want to fine-tune models,
right.
Then that needs to happen in a bit of a closed ecosystem that we can make sure that we have all the proper controls in place.
Yeah.
And that's where
the
AWS
more.
Environment is crucial for us.
Take those first two-way door risks, right? Get a feedback loop going, optimize it before you then take it out to the customer and scale.
Yeah.
You mentioned a bit more around like some of the regulatory and legal challenges and the fact that you're actually now, you know, engaging on the ethics side of things as well. Like any kind of like areas of concern around like ethics when, you know, you think about some of the Gen AI apps at scale that you might deliver through Booking.com?
You know, I think, again, none of them are specific to Booking. I think the
right.
things that everybody has to keep in mind right. with the, you know, explosion of this technology. So for me, what's crucial is transparency. I think
right.
the more we can be transparent about the predictions that we're making and what data we've used, how we've used it, is I think that's a really important piece to maintaining trust.
Yeah. You have an exciting you know, future coming up right now as you start to migrate and modernize as well all of that data. What are your considerations around future skill sets for your team? What they need to learn, what they need to invest in as they start to drive more incremental value into the business with data?
I think from an engineering perspective, you know, we, in some ways, I feel like we've also really just gotten started making use
yeah.
of public cloud as well. So, you know, that it's a different way of building. You know, right. When you start taking managed services that are already integrated with each other and you start to realize that things actually build on top of themselves, you know, so those things that Swami was talking about, ETL list solutions,
right.
If you're making use of Dynamo, if you're making use of Aurora, then that makes life so much easier when it comes to, you know, or I love the story around the vector databases along with your operational stores.
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
It's great to see that in.
And that just that way of thinking is a different way of building. And I think there's just more training and you know, exposure I need to do with my own teams to make sure that they're seeing what's possible.
No, I fully agree. And I mean, what does your internal customer audience look like? You know, you have a lot of different business teams, I'm sure, that are very hungry for data, that want to do more with AI right now.
Yeah.
What are their skill sets like? How are you helping them to lean in more? We heard quite a lot from Swami about things like QuickSight Q and like some of the new generative AI that helps business users to be able to consume insight more effectively. Are you thinking about any of those things?
Yeah, we think about them. But, you know, funny enough, I would say, you know, at Booking, I'm less concerned about the data science skill. We are a longtime data science practitioners. So that's well in our wheelhouse. So I'm less concerned about the skills in the data science community. It's more just, you know, making the technology available for them to just make it easier for them, quite honestly. And that's kind of what I was describing in the keynote today as well. The, you know, they were so happy when we, you know, started making SageMaker available, they could do more things. And we're just going to see more and more of that for them.
Fantastic. One of the things I've been speaking to a lot of customers about is stay focused on what's valuable for your customer and your business. Keep working backwards from that to the right solution. There's a risk right now, especially with all the hype around GenAI, that people just deploy LLMs for just no real reason.
Yes.
Maybe they become lost language models instead of large language models eventually.
Yes.
What are the things that, you know, you're staying focused on as you think about like continuing to drive really compelling customer experiences?
Yeah, you're exactly right. I think we watched in the travel space, it's such a common example that people use for GenAI. But and so we saw, you know, some, you know, plugins start to show up, but it was use the plugin and then go back. Now you've sort of had this interaction, but it wasn't well integrated.
Right.
So we wanted to make sure that we brought something that was actually valuable. So that was where we really thought that, hey, why don't we actually just integrate this nicely with our environment and embed the carousel right into the AI trip planner so that someone could book right in the app versus, okay, you've had this great conversational interaction. Now we've told you, go use the old way versus do it right seamlessly in there. So that was something we wanted to have that customer experience go all the way through to a booking.
That's really great. And I think like there's two kind of like critical considerations now when we think about generative AI. One is the user interface. It's a new way of consuming and interacting with technology and information. And I think what you did in that first app is a great way of doing that differently. But the second is all the rich data that you have. You know, you mentioned around all of the comments around travel and how you're able to use that to fine-tune the model to create more of a differentiator. And Swami speaks a lot about data being your differentiator when it comes to AI as well. And so like, what are your thoughts on that?
Yeah, no doubt. I think that especially if you're going to be building or tuning your own models, then you've got to be able to trust your data. And I would go back to also, let's be sure that, you know, PII or personally identifiable information is not creeping into those models.
Yeah.
So you've got to have enterprise grade, you know, controls around that data before you start doing something like building your own LLMs.
Yeah, yeah. Security is going to be really important. And governance around it is really important as well.
Sure.
We spoke about choice as well today. Being able to select the right FMs that, you know, essentially match with the use case that you need as well.
Yeah.
I mean, how important is that for Booking.com?
Oh, massively important. Yeah. You know, have you ever met an engineer who's not opinionated?
Right.
So, you know, but we like being able to play with Llama, we play with Claude, you know, we've played with some of the other, you know, open source models as well. And that's great for us. So we really think that AWS has done the right thing by enabling choice.
Great. Well, that's really awesome. One of the things I see more increasingly now that's fundamental, not only to AI, but just to using data at scale across an organization is really thinking about data as a product as well. And really getting, you know, a product-centric mindset towards creating data that is accessible by a wide variety of audiences across the business, but is still uniform and consistent in how it's defined. And things like, you know, Traveler as a single kind of like data product, I'm sure might be quite important at Booking.com. Like, how do you guys think about data in that perspective? Do you think about it as a product as well? Or do you have a different view?
Yeah, internally. I mean, in some ways, so Traveler or Customer is the way we think about it. Trip is a thing unto itself. So in that way, we kind of think about data models in that way. But I would kind of go back to one of the things that my teams hear from me consistently is you have to be looking at the data regularly to trust it.
Right.
So a lot of that is also, you know, process. It's not just the data itself.
Yeah.
So I always tell my teams that, you know, the key word in being data-driven is driven. not data. So the more that you drive yourself with the data, the quality of the data will follow.
Well, look, it's been a pleasure speaking.
Yeah.
Really thankful for all the insights and really excited for what you guys are doing over at Bookingcom.
Thank you for the time. Yeah.